Hello. This is a love reading for the sign of Capricorn from April 4th to April 11th. Your universal love oracle card is Tantric Union. And I'm just going to read to you what it says here. Spiritual energy infuses all things. It is the flow of creation that spirals constantly in search of greater union. This energy is made up of opposite forces that constantly split and merge with one another. Spiritual energy is therefore also sexual in nature. A spiritual sexual union exists between all things. Within humanity, this union can be experienced through the spiritual or physical planes. Your spiritual sexual energy is being aroused at this time, creating a deep desire to connect to another. If you are currently in a relationship, then expect your relationship to deepen. Tantric union is much more than the merging of two people. It is a union of opposite parts that connect to form a whole. Though this merger, the gateway to creation opens as we enter the realm of oneness. I think there is a typo there. It says, though this merger. I think it meant through this merger, the gateway to creation opens as we enter the realm of oneness. This union needs not to be restricted to solely the physical. Tantric union can also be a solely spiritual one, for it is above all the merging of twin souls. Okay, so I went ahead and I laid your cards out ahead of time because if I don't, your videos would be extremely long because I guess I'm just slow. I don't know. I like to take my time when I do my readings. Sometimes I go quicker than other times, because I'm usually very busy, and I still want to always make time to do what I'm passionate about. So, excuse me. So please, let's see what we have here. We have. Oh, what do we have here? The Ten of Cups in reverse. Okay. You have the Four of Cups in reverse. And you have the Seven of Cups in reverse. Real strong water energy here. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Yeah. Capricorn, what is going on? Who did you meet? I'm a little jelly. Tantric union, really? Sounds nice. Okay, so we also have 10 and 4 and 7. So 4, 7, 3. So you're feeling a very strong connection with this individual. And I think that I strongly get the feeling that you maybe you're being a little unrealistic about your expectations because of all this tantric love going on. Why wouldn't you want that, right? But I feel like there's a combination of grasping too tightly, not giving them enough room. And this could go either way. This could be them doing this to you as well. Yeah. And I feel that you're having fun with them. You have the Page of Swords here as your overall energy. So you guys are having fun, you know? You're enjoying this connection. But if you don't leave room for the imagination, or not even the imagination, but just, you know, don't go in at a 10, full speed ahead, you know. Kind of play and have fun. Don't be so serious. Okay. Now, I feel because of these, I feel that there was a lot of seriousness really fast. And you have this rune here on the Seven of Cups in reverse. And this is the Cross Spears. And this indicates that there's arguments. And so I think maybe, you know, these arguments had to do with other people that are around you. You know, interfering, not really interfering, just being around a lot of other people and having that seriousness, you know, can bring up arguments. Gotta keep it fun and light, playful. And your rune here on the Ten of Cups in reverse is the Ear of Corn, which is pretty amazing because, I mean, the Ear of Corn is like the Ten of Cups. It's about abundance, success, happiness, joy, you know, being joyful, feeling complete. You know, you got the Ten of Cups, you got everything you could possibly want or need, and more. Yeah. So if you're dealing with, if you're dealing with a water sign, you know, maybe a Pisces, we want to turn this around. We want this upright. Excuse me. I got a little bit of a scratchy throat. So how are we going to turn that around, Capricorn? We're going to keep things light, fun, and playful. No more seriousness. All right. Now, on your outcome, We have the Five of Pentacles. The Lovers. And the Nine of Wands. So, if you keep the seriousness up, what's going to end up happening is someone's going to walk away. Or, like I said, it could be them being that way. Maybe they're, you know, maybe they're just really into you and was enjoying this tantric love with you. Maybe they're just insecure. Maybe they're feeling left out in the cold by you with the Five of Pentacles. This can be a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. So, and on that card, you have the Sun. Okay. And again, this is success and a positive outcome. So, you know, if the outcome is that one of you is feeling left out in the cold, you know, it's going to end up in a positive outcome. And the reason why I say that is because right next to that, right, you have the Lovers. And on top of the Lovers is the Rune. Rings. And I feel like this is a soulmate because this is the infinity symbol, the rings. See that? Okay. I feel like there's a choice that needs to be made right now. This may be for another group of you, but I feel like there is a choice that needs to be made between a Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, or an Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. If you're involved with an Aries, Leo, or Sagittarius, this guy is being extremely defensive. Okay, look at him. And I also see with the Five of Wands, there's a lot of arguments going on. Petty arguments. Alright, so the rings is this is the Rune of Love. Okay? The opposite of this. We want this with this. So, and you have free will. I mean, all I can do is just tell you the different things that I feel and see. It's your choice. It's always your choice. You can always change whatever you don't want in your life. At any time. It's solely up to you. I will tell you this. You're going to have progress in your career, and you're going to have a successful, happy marriage. But you may have to go through feeling left out in the cold, or they may, for a time being. And, right now I feel like this is the energy. Right here, the Ace of Cups in reverse. But I'm gonna pull some clarifiers too. Why is the Ten of Cups here in reverse for Capricorn? One card from the Spirit. Give me a sun sign. One of them almost came out. Let's find out. Why is this Ten of Cups in reverse for Capricorn Spirit? One sun sign, please. Please clarify this. Okay. All right. Well, it gave me two, so maybe it's for two different groups of you. Or maybe it's for one of you dealing with two different, several different people have made you feel that way. So clarifying the Ten of Cups in reverse is the Seven of Wands, which represents Leo, and the Queen of Swords, which represents Libra, Gemini, or Aquarius. But this person may carry themselves like a Virgo. Could be male or female. I see that somebody is feeling like everybody's against them. You see that? This guy, he's got all these people coming at him with his wands. And he's like, get back, get back. Someone's feeling defensive, possibly a fire sign. Aries, Leo, Sag, leaning more towards Leo. And this energy here, this Queen of Swords, she don't take no crap from nobody. She gonna tell them how it is. All right. Why is the Five of Pentacles? Oh, someone's feeling past regrets, sorrow. Possibly a Scorpio. Scorpio could be feeling left out in the cold, forgotten. They're just sitting around thinking about what they used to have. Okay. Why is the Lovers here? Can you give me one card, please? Clarify the Lovers for Capricorn. Okay. You have the Queen of Pentacles. So this is Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn. Okay, fire or earth? Sagittarius, Capricorn. But this is also you. This is your energy, Capricorn. This could be your energy. Because you're showing up because it's your reading. Okay. Can you clarify the Queen of Pentacles? Can you give me a sun sign? Why the Lovers and the Queen of Pentacles is here, please. For Capricorn. One card, please. One card. Okay, I have to shuffle. Okay, these cards are becoming resistant all of a sudden. Alright, we have the Three of Pentacles, which also represents Capricorn, also represents partnerships. Can you clarify the Three of Pentacles, please? Just one card. I have to shuffle again. Sorry if your video is long, Capricorn. Sometimes I can get so deep into these readings, I lose track of time. Clarify the Three of Pentacles, please, Spirit, Capricorn. Why is the Three of Pentacles here? I have one card, please. Who are they having a partnership with? As their outcome. Okay, the energies are starting to flow again. This one. And Aries. Okay. I see Pisces. Yeah, Aries. Okay. This Emperor looks angry. You got the Emperor in reverse, clarifying the Three of Pentacles. Wow. Somebody's not using their intuition about this Aries. And this Aries is pissed off. And he's still waiting. Yeah, the Sun in reverse. I think he's growing a little bit impatient, waiting on you. Whoever this Aries is, I don't even know if this is for the same group. But there is an Aries right now that is peed off about a partnership. Why is the Sun here in reverse? Give me one card, please. One. Just one. Like I said, this Aries. He was waiting on you. The Hanged Man. But it's in reverse. So maybe he's not waiting on you anymore. And he's got the death card in reverse. So even though he's not waiting on you, he's not ending it either. He's still holding on. So he may not be waiting for you. But he's not letting the cycle end either. Okay. Let me find out why this Ace of Cups is here in reverse. Why is the Ace of Cups here in reverse for Capricorn? One card, this one. Alright, well, give me two. So, Virgo, Taurus, Capricorn, this is your energy. This is the Empress. Not offering your emotions to the King of Wands, which is an Aries. Yep. And you walked away. The Eight of Cups. Pisces energy. Maybe you walked away to be with a Pisces. Or maybe they walked away from a Pisces to be with you. Interesting. Okay. I think that's pretty much all I have for Capricorn. Yeah. That was a good reading. I mean, it wasn't all like rainbows and butterflies, but I felt the energy so strongly. The messages. And don't forget the message too, you know. Stay playful. Have fun. Enjoy this tantric love, but don't squeeze, don't hold too tightly. Keep things light and playful. Okay. Oh, and I'm listening to 639 frequency, attract love, raise positive energy, marimba meditation music on YouTube. And if you like these runes I've been using, they're the witch's runes. And if you like to purchase some, you can go to www.dragonoak.com. That's where I purchased them from. Anyways, I'm experimenting with them. This is like the third time I've used them. I really like them though. Please let me know what you think. Please feel free to like, share, comment below. Yeah. And I'll see you again soon. Thank you.